or audio and video recording of any kind is strictly prohibited by law without prior permission by the College of the Arts. Food and drinks are not allowed in the auditorium. Out of respect for the performers and those around you, please do not talk during the event, and if you must leave, do so during the pause between pieces or at intermission. Thank you for your attendance and your patronage. Please enjoy the performance, and we hope to see you again soon.
Good evening and welcome. My name is David Springfield. I'm the Director of Jazz Studies here at Valdosta State University. I'm going to keep this very minimal because we have four bands to perform for you this evening and we want to play as much music as possible and really have a lot of fun. So we're so happy you're here and joining us. This is a really special event. We've been doing this so long, I can't really remember how many years it's been at this point, but it's been for a while, and it's something we look forward to every year. It doesn't always work out this way, but this year it does, and every once in a while it does, that this concert falls on Mardi Gras, and so today is Mardi Gras, so that's pretty awesome. It's a great reminder about the origins of jazz, going back to the city of New Orleans and being a really important part of that city's culture and history, and I think even if we're not doing things specifically New Orleans related, the spirit of jazz comes from that place. And at the end, we're going to do something that's very specifically Mardi Gras and have some fun with that as well. So we're going to get things started here. This is a really fun event. We've got four bands. We've got our two college groups and two high schools to perform for you this evening. And so I always say we're very lucky to here at Valdosta State University to have enough student interest and participation to offer two full jazz ensembles. And so this is our new jazz ensemble here on stage. And we're also very lucky this year to have a really great experienced educator. He retired, but he's really not retired because you never really retire being a musician and being a teacher. And he's such a great teacher. I was so happy that he was able to join us and be teaching and leading this group this year. So I'm going to turn things over to him. This is the VSU New Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Mr. Curt Kimbrough.
Tucker Browning on keyboard. Tucker Browning. That opening tune is called Breezy Sock Blues. We kind of renamed it Ode to Five Guys. If you've ever been to Five Guys restaurant and got fries, you know you left with a greasy sack. Greasy Sack Blues. Composer there is Don Rader. Don Rader is a trumpet player who toured throughout Australia and has an enormous discography of jazz tunes, but this particular one was made more famous by the Woody Herman Big Band. You'll find a lot of his recordings of Greasy Sack Blues out there. We love to play standards. I like for young people to know the importance of playing standards, and our next tune is definitely a standard composed by George and Ira Gershwin. Interesting point about this, this is the last tune that George Gershwin composed before his passing. And a little few years later, his brother Ira Gershwin added the lyrics to this. And this has been performed by every major vocalist in jazz, from Sinatra to Tony Bennett, Nat King Cole, everybody. So we're gonna do our version, arranged by Rick Stitzel. This is Love Is Here to Stay. I had the privilege and pleasure of playing this concert 4 years ago now as the director at Tiff County High School, and had a great program that night, so I decided to go back and pull a tune that we played on that night. And this is called Blue Note Special. Gonna feature a couple of folks on solos. Got Lance Digpin on tenor sax, Natalie Savoy on trombone. This is Blue Note Special. Mr. Springfield told us we got a lot of good music here today, so we're gonna hurry up, get the band ready and find the score. We're gonna hurry up, get out of the way. I want to invite you to come back out in April. This band will be featured on our own concert. I think it's April 16, Tuesday night. And that following Thursday, the Jazz Ensemble will have its concert in April. So watch out for those dates. We'd love to have you back. And we're going to play these four and three or four more that night. But we're going to close our portion of the concert tonight with some swinging funk. This is a Julian Cannonball Adderley tune rearranged for us by Mr. Mark Taylor. This is called Sack of Wool. Sack of Wool. Was round one. You warmed up yet? All right, we got three more rounds of this. And so we're going to make our way off, guys, this way and find us a seat. And we'll be back in just a minute with an amazing guest that we have, Houston County Jazz Ensemble. Looking forward to it. Y'all give us a minute. Thank you.
Curt already introduced them, but I'll reintroduce them. Really excited to have this group here. They've come a long way, but every time I ask, and I know how far they're gonna, it's 2 hours to Warner Robins, it's a school night, but I think you responded to my email like instantly and said, they're gonna be here, and so we're so happy to have them here. I've known Jay for a while now, and it's really fantastic to have his band here. So, Houston County High School Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Mr. Jay Davis.
Thank you. talk. This is what they do to the new guy. It's my first time, so I think we're just here. We're thrilled to be here. We're the Houston County High School Jazz Ensemble from Warner Robins. As Springfield said, I'm Jay Davis, band director. And just wanted to, the first thing we did was a classic jazz standard, Thad Jones arrangement of Groove Merchant, featuring our outstanding saxophone section. How about another great one? We are going to feature one of our sax players, our lead alto, Mr. Brett Williams, playing one of the most prolific jazz composers ever, Mr. Sammy Nesico. We're going to feature him on a ballad called Samantha. I think it's a me problem.
try this one again. Is that better? Again, that was Mr. Brett Williams. He's a senior at House of King High School. How about another hand? Again, I just cannot say thank you enough to David Springfield and all the great folks here at Valdosta State. It is truly an honor to come and play. It's nice to see that jazz is alive and well in the state of Georgia, and we hope this continues to grow and expand and add even more groups to events like this. We're going to play one more song for you this evening. This is a very great arrangement by Elliot Deutsch of a very familiar song. This is Pure Imagination from the Willy Wonka movies. Oh, this is going to feature a couple people. Jamari's going to play a little bit of stuff on the keyboard. We've also got Mr. Drew Bragg on tenor sax. Drew also just finished up as lead tenor in the All-State Jazz Band, so Drew's going to play for you. And Mr. Jason Peters also on tenor sax. This is Elliot Deutsch's Pure Imagination. Thank you. said, next up, round three. Thank you.
this group almost needs no introduction, certainly not in their hometown. They've been a part of every one of these events that we've done. That kind of was the whole meaning behind the Titletown Jazz Concert, to feature, you know, the groups right here in our hometown. We're so proud of them anyway. I need to brag on them a little bit. I bet a lot of you know this, but some of you may not, that last month, this group, the Valdosta High School Jazz Ensemble, was one of only two high school jazz ensembles in the entire state of Georgia to be accepted and invited to perform at the Georgia Music Educators Conference up in Athens, Georgia. So I think they deserve a round of applause for that. So I was lucky enough to be there in person and hear them, and they did a fantastic job. And so it's really going to be a pleasure to have them play some of that music again here this evening and to hear them perform it again. So without any further ado, Valdosta High School Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Mr. Andrew Hill.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That featured Mr. Travis Kimbrough on tenor sax. I want to give him another hand. Also featured Mr. Jaden Gray on drums. Give him a hand. Strike Up the Band, famous Gershwin classic, arranged by Sammy Nesko for the Count Basie Orchestra. If you want a tune that really swings, look up Sammy Nesko. You'll get a chart that really, really swings. We're going to move right along and bring you all our next selection, an oldie goldie, first recorded back in 1941 by Jimmy Dorsey, clarinet, alto saxophone player, and was re-recorded by numerous artists, to include Sonny Rollins. Is going to feature tonight our vocalist, Miss Isis Lorenzo. We hope you enjoy. Lorenzo. And Mr. Dennis Savoy on tenor saxophone. We're going to move right along and bring you our next tune entitled Yes Indeed, based on one of my sayings at Valdosta High School, Yes Indeed, composed by the great arranger composer, Mr. David Springfield. Thank you. This piece depicts me pretty well. He's been paying attention down through the years since 2004, I believe 20 years. So yes, he has a right. Down through the years, 20 years, it depicts me pretty well. I'm easygoing, I like jazz, I like gospel. You hear a few gospel chords throughout. And so this is Yes Indeed. It's gonna feature Mr. Stephen Hodges on the piano. We hope you enjoy Yes Indeed.
Thank you.
Stephen Hodges on piano. Mr. David Springfield. Going to leave you all with a tune entitled A Warm Breeze. It was a track title to a Count Basie album, I believe from 1970, from Sammy Nestico. It's going to feature Mr. Stephen Hodges at the very top. It's going to feature Mr. Angelo Vasquez on tenor saxophone, Mr. Tyler Freilich on trumpet, and also Mr. David Springfield on trombone. We hope you enjoy A Warm Breeze.
Thank you very much. We are the VSU Jazz Ensemble. We opened up with a tune that kind of goes back to the big band era, Stomping at the Savoy. The Savoy Ballroom was one of the main dancing and big band establishments in New York City that was really popular during that time. The tune was made famous by the Benny Goodman Big Band. The version we played was from a little bit later on, the Stan Kenton Big Band, a famous arrangement done by the great Bill Holman. We featured, let me see if I can remember everybody, we featured some bass solos from Yonder Tyler on the bass. Guitar from Isaiah Perez. Matthew Sebrin on tenor saxophone. And Autumn Bucking on the trumpet. We're gonna continue, it's all about, it has been great to hear so many varieties of styles and change of, you know, of mood and different historical things this evening. Jazz has so many varieties to it, and for a music that's really only about 100 years old, it's really amazing. It's one of the things I find really exciting about it. So we're gonna change pace completely. We're gonna do a piece written by a really important jazz pianist and composer that originally came from Japan. And it's a woman composer as well, Toshiko Akiyoshi, but she's lived most of her life in the United States and made her career in the United States, and she not only was a great piano player, but she led her own big band. She may have been one of the first women jazz musicians to lead her own band and compose all the music for the group as well. Really great composer. A lot of her music, I told the students, is very difficult. It's very challenging. She writes at a very professional level, lots of different woodwind doublings in the saxophones and stuff like that. But we found a piece that's a little bit more accessible. It's kind of a nice change of pace. It fits the title. It's a little more relaxed. This was called Lazy Day. But we found there's still some challenging things, and there's still some really unique qualities about her writing that's been a real challenge to work on, but fun to work on, and a nice change of pace. We're going to hear some saxophone solos on this one. We're going to hear Christian Vasquez from Valdosta High School. Also saxophone. And on the baritone saxophone, we're going to hear Seth Lee from Ware County High School. Next year when we do this concert, I want to be able to announce somebody from Houston County that's in one of these groups as well. So we can't wait for you to join us here at VSU. So here's Toshiko Akiyoshi's Lazy Day.
Thank you.
another change of pace, and this is a piece that I arranged, and actually I want to give another shout out to Valdosta High School. I've done this to them publicly before, but it was an honor to hear them bring my piece to life in their performance earlier today, because as composers and arrangers, you know, we can sit on our computers and come up with ideas and plug music in, that sort of thing, but it takes real live musicians to make the music happen and bring to life. So thank you again for another great performance. Yeah. So this is a piece that actually has a really interesting origin. This was a piece that was written by one of my teachers originally. Fred Sturm was one of my jazz composition and arranging teachers when I was in school. And he wrote this piece originally. He was a great composer arranger, wrote great jazz ensemble music and things like that. He wrote this piece for piano originally, and that's where I first discovered it. It was a piece, just a very short piano piece, just really beautiful that I heard. And when I heard it, it was pretty sentimental to me because he passed away. And I heard this kind of right before he passed away, or maybe right afterwards. And you know, I had a real attachment to me and his importance to me. And I heard this piece and I was like, I think maybe I could do something with this piece and arrange it and orchestrate it for the jazz ensemble, sort of my own little tribute to him. And so that's kind of where this came from. And it's jazz, it's for the jazz ensemble, but it's also kind of a concert piece of music. There aren't really any individual solos. It's all about blend and intonation and all those things. And that was something that Fred was really interested in, about crossing over between different genres of music and treating the jazz ensemble a little bit like a wind ensemble sometimes. And that's kind of what I tried to capture with this piece. And so it's really been fun working on this. And we played this about, I think I wrote it about 10 years ago or something like that. So it's been fun to bring it out again and have the students work on it. So hopefully some really nice colors and some blends, and we really hope you enjoy my arrangement of Fred Sturm's Breathing.
Thank you.
All right, changing the style again. One of the real great success stories in jazz, you know, jazz has a long history, but we don't necessarily think of jazz as being popular anymore. But every once in a while, there's a song, or in this case, a band that comes along. And one of the bands that has really been successful in the last 10 years or so, not only with winning Grammys and awards and things like that, but just, you know, the acclaim that they've achieved, the level of success, when you see videos and you see the amount of people that come out for their concerts and sort of crossing over, is the band Snarky Puppy. And actually, I'm getting old enough now, when they came on the scene, it was really some of my students who kind of told me about them. I was too old to kind of know what the new thing on the scene was. There, have you checked out the Snarky Puppy band? I think you'd like it. It's pretty cool. And as soon as I listened to them, I was blown away. Just incredible musicianship. They cross over so many different styles. And there was one tune of theirs in particular that I heard, and I was like, that's a really cool piece. And I think that might work pretty well for the jazz ensemble. And so this is the one we're going to do for you to kind of finish our portion of the evening before we have our big grand finale here. So we're gonna feature on this one, well, definitely our rhythm section as a whole. We couldn't do this piece. Snarky Puppy, they're a rhythm section heavy band. They have horns in it, but they've got like three guitars and three keyboard players and percussionists and all this stuff. And so the rhythm section is gonna really hold everything down for us on this one. But we're gonna hear Tyrese McGauley on a solo towards the end of this one, so we'll hear that. And in the middle, we're gonna have Brody Johnson on a trumpet solo in this one as well. So this is Snarky Puppy's Shofukan, and that's a Japanese word. And somebody asked me, and I hadn't answered it yet. The composer is the bass player of the group, Michael League, and he was spending some time in Europe, and there was a Japanese cultural center there called Shofukan, and that's where he wrote this piece, so that's where the title came from. I don't know, we'd have to get a Japanese expert to tell us what it means, but that's where it comes from at least. So this is Snarky Puppy's Shofukan. Thank you. All right, Mardi Gras time. Let's get all of our ensembles to join us up here on stage. Valdosta High School, Houston County High School, VSU New Jazz Ensemble, come on out and join us. Shy. We're going to bring a little New Orleans right here to Valdosta this evening. Do a traditional New Orleans second line piece. It's actually called Second Line. The only thing we're missing is the parade, so, but we're still going to have some fun. We'll be right back.